So at the segmental level, these are the factors which are responsible for control of the muscle tone at the level of the spinal cord. So number one is stress reflex. All of you know when the muscle is stressed, what will happen? The intrafusal muscle fibers will be undergo stretching. So primary efferent fibers will be carried to the level of the spinal cord. Alpha motor neuron will be stimulated, and because of alpha motor neuron stimulation, extrafusal muscle fiber will be contracted. Ultimately, what will happen? If the extrafusal muscle fiber is contracted, there will be muscle contraction, and because of the muscle contraction, the muscle tone will be regulated. So stress reflex is very much important at the level of the spinal cord, which controls the development of muscle tone. So we should not forget that a muscle tone is most important stimulus for development of muscle tone is a stretch. So stress reflex is very much important, which is integrated at the level of spinal cord and ultimately level, controls the muscle tone. So second important factor is pain. Pain is very much important actually. Why? Because pain increases the gamma motor neuron discharge via descending fibers. So pain, when there is a feeling of pain, we see that there is a rigidity. There is a muscular rigidity at the site of pain. When there is a pain, the muscles around the site of pain, there will be rigidity or muscle tone will increase. So at the site of pain, what we will see? The muscle tone will increase and there will be a rigidity, and it is because of pain, the pain stimulus will stimulate the it will stimulate the gamma motor neuron discharge, and ultimately muscle tone will increase. Okay, that's why around the site of injury we will see as muscle hypertonia or rigidity. Okay, and this is integrated at the level of segmental level or spinal cord level. Another important factor is interneurons. You know, interneurons at the level of spinal cord is very much important, because interneuron ultimately responsible for inhibition of the two motor neurons, alpha motor neuron and gamma motor neuron. Okay, so there are these interneurons. So once the alpha motor neuron and gamma motor neuron is inhibited, what will happen? Muscle tone will be inhibited. So interneurons which are normally inhibited in nature will inhibit the alpha motor neuron and gamma motor neuron, which is an important stimulus. All of you know, alpha motor neuron stimulates causes muscle tone directly, and gamma motor neuron indirectly leads to increase in the muscle tone. So muscle tone is controlled by the two more important alpha motor neuron, gamma motor neuron, and interneuron will inhibit the alpha motor neuron, gamma motor neuron, and ultimately inhibits the muscle tone at the level of the spinal cord. And there are two types of inhibition. We can give example Golgi bottle neuron. So Golgi bottle neuron is a neuron which is also present in the spinal cord, which is inhibited in nature. Another one is Renshaw cell inhibition. Renshaw cell is another type of cell which is integrated at the level of spinal cord, which is also inhibitory, which inhibited the alpha and gamma motor neuron and responsible for suppression of the muscle tone. And last one is the Golgi tendon organ. Golgi tendon organ, I have already explained, these are proprioceptors of the muscle tendon and formed by the terminals of the 1B fibers. Now what is happening is that when you stimulate the Golgi tendon organ, it will stimulate the interneuron of the spinal cord, suppresses the alpha motor neuron and gamma motor neuron discharge, and ultimately leads to the decrease in the muscle tone and decrease in the muscle contraction. So all these factors proves that the spinal cord level, the regulation of muscle tone also happens. And spinal cord is a very important structure where at this level various factors plays important role in regulation of the muscle tone. Number one is stress reflex. All of you know stretch is an important part. Without stress, there is no passive muscle resistance cannot be checked. So stress reflex are integrated at the level of spinal cord via muscle spindle, and muscle tone is regulated via the stress reflex. And next important point is pain. When there is a pain, the gamma motor neuron discharge will be there. And all of you know, when there is a gamma motor neuron discharge, muscle spindle will be contracted, and once muscle spindle contracted, so what will be there? There will be hypertonia or rigidity. And next important factor is interneurons. There are two types of interneurons, Golgi bottle in a Renshaw cell. They are inhibiting the alpha and the gamma motor neuron discharge and control the muscle tone. And Golgi tendon organ, they are, all of you know, they are proprioceptors of the tendon of the muscle. They are also responsible for inhibition of the muscle tone and inhibits the muscle contraction. Okay, so these are the segmental control of the muscle tone at the level of spinal cord. Next one we'll see suprasegmental level. Suprasegmental control or regulation. So suprasegmental, this is the first point. Next point is suprasegmental. Suprasegmental control of muscle tone. So suprasegmental control of muscle tone. So number one structure is, I already told, cerebral cortex. Number two is basal ganglia. Number three is cerebellum. So all of you know cerebellar cortex is very much important actually. I told you it always plays important role in inhibition of the muscle growth. So in after cerebellectomy or removal of the cerebral cortex, as we see cerebral decortication, cerebral cortex is removed, we will see inhibition, muscle tone is increased or rigidity. This proves that cerebral cortex plays important role in inhibition of muscle tone via pyramidal fibers or descending fibers and controls the alpha motor neuron discharge at the level of the spinal cord. Okay, so cerebral cortex inhibits the muscle tone via the pyramidal tract or corticospinal tract, which inhibits the alpha motor neuron discharge and controls the muscle tone. Next is basal ganglia. Basal ganglia is also a group of subcortical structure that plays very much important role in control of the muscle tone. Via how? Via, because this is out of the 3-4 area. It is among the 3-4 areas which is gives inhibitory impulse to the brainstem. Reticular activity is controlled and ultimately controls the activity of the spinal cord. Okay, so basal ganglia is very much important structure that controls the activity of the muscle tone by suppressing the reticular activity of the brainstem and ultimately controlling the alpha motor neuron discharge. So in basal ganglia also is an inhibitory effect. So basal ganglia has an inhibitory effect on the muscle tone. So after what we will see, that's why in case of Parkinsonism, you know Parkinsonism is a disease where there is a defect of the or lesion in the basal ganglia. Substantia nigra, there is a dopaminergic neurons of the substantia nigra is damaged. And that's why there you will see the muscle tone is increased in Parkinsonism. So basal ganglia lesion leads to increase the muscle tone, which proves that basal ganglia plays an important role in suppressing the muscle tone. Okay, so basal ganglia has an inhibitory effect on the muscle tone. Next one is cerebellum. Cerebellum actually, all of you know, is a center for motor learning and it is responsible for anticipation of movement, programming of the movement, planning of movements, final movements, and also the site for motor learning. So cerebellum, here actually, it is also affect the muscle tone and there is a inhibition of the muscle tone from cerebellum, because it also gives inhibitory stimulus on the reticular activity of the brain stem and ultimately at the level of the spinal cord, it causes inhibition of the muscle tone. So this muscle tone is in. Now in case of cerebellar lesions, we will see hypotonia. So when there is a cerebellar lesions, there will be hypotonia, and if you remove the cerebellum, cerebellectomy, muscle tone will be increased. After cerebellectomy, muscle tone will be increased, there will be rigidity, and in case of cerebellar lesions, we will see hypotonia, but muscle tone will decrease. And overall, the role of cerebellum is it inhibits the muscle tone. And next is the brainstem. So brainstem is very much important actually. I told you it contains one important nuclei known as reticular nuclei. And reticular nuclei, it has both excitatory area and inhibitory area. So brainstem can control the muscle tone, both increase or decrease the muscle tone. It can increase the muscle tone via stimulation of the excitatory area of the reticular activity, reticular nuclei of the brainstem, and it can also decrease the muscle tone by stimulation of the inhibitory area of the reticular activity or reticular nuclei of the brainstem. So, and all other areas, cerebral cortex, basal ganglia, cerebellum, are ultimately controlling the spinal cord via the brainstem through the reticular nucleus. So, when it comes to brainstem, the reticular nuclei is plays an important role. It has both excitatory area and inhibitory area, and it can both excite the muscle and for responsible for increase the muscle tone, or it can decrease the muscle tone. So, it does either action of the muscle tone. It can both increase the muscle tone, or again it can decrease the muscle tone. Okay, so these are the various suprasegmental control of the muscle tone. Suprasegmental control of the muscle tone. Okay, so what are the various exciting areas? Only which area is responsible for exciting increase in the muscle tone? So in muscle tone is increased because of brainstem, reticular activity. And what are the structure which inhibits the muscle tone? Cerebral cortex, basal ganglia, cerebellum. Can you understand? So almost majority of the part of the brain inhibits the muscle tone. Only the sub part of brainstem inhibits the muscle tone, but so muscle tone is increased via at the level of spinal cord. Can you understand? So spinal cord is very much important why a muscle tone is increased. Muscle tone is increased mainly because of activity of the spinal cord. Whereas other part of higher CNS will always as a majority of them has an inhibitory effect on the muscle tone. Can you understand? Next we will jump to what are the other various factors other than this segmental and the suprasegmental control. Any other control is there? Yes, there are other controls. We call it various other factor or other factors. Number one we can write anxiety. When you are anxious, when you are tense, muscle tone will be increased. So muscle tone will be increased because of anxiety. This is because of increased gamma motor neuron discharge and via extra pyramidal and pyramidal tracts. Via pyramidal tracts or the listening fibers, anxiety causes discharge of the gamma motor neuron, and because of the discharge of the gamma motor neuron, what will happen? Gamma motor neuron activity, ultimately it will increase the muscle tone. Okay, so anxiety will always increase the muscle tone. So this is another important factor. Next important factor is sleep. All of you know, when you are sleeping, what is happening? Your muscle tone will decrease. Can you understand? This is because the sleep suppresses the gamma motor neuron discharge. Sleep suppresses the gamma motor neuron discharge, and this is mediated by a pyramidal tracts. So pain or sleep, when you are sleeping, muscle tone is relaxed, muscle undergoes relaxation and muscle tone will decrease. This is because of pyramidal tract stimulus. So via pyramidal tract, when you are sleeping, the pyramidal tracts will bring a stimulus and ultimately it will suppress the gamma motor neuron discharge at the level of spinal cord, and there is a decrease in the muscle tone. So you will see decrease of muscle tone in case of sleep. So in sleep, you will see decrease of the muscle tone. So any other important factor? Yes, muscle tone is also regulated by another factor known as posterior reflex. In various posterior reflexes also, muscle tone is also controlled. Muscle tone may be increased in case of posterior reflexes also. Then some drugs. All of you know sedatives. Sedatives, then tranquilizers. All actually decrease the muscle tone by affecting on the CNS. Okay, so various drugs also controlling the muscle tone. So number, what are the other various factors which control the muscle tone? Number one is anxiety. Anxiety always increase the gamma motor activity via the pyramidal tract or extrapyramidal tracts, and ultimately muscle tone will be increased. In sleep, there is a suppression of the gamma motor neuron discharge leading to decrease in the muscle tone, and various posterior reflexes are also associated with muscle tone. And drugs, various drugs like sedatives, tranquilizers, they also play an important role in controlling the muscle tone. Okay, now we shift to various applied aspects of the muscle tone. Various applied aspects of the muscle tone. So you should know one important term known as hypertonia. What is hypertonia? Hypertonia means a condition where there is increase in the muscle tone. So there are two types. What are those? Spasticity and rigidity. In spasticity, there are two types: cogwheel type and rigidity is two type and lead pipe type. Okay, spasticity you can see in case of upper motor neuron lesion in hemiplegia, okay. Now we see what is hypertonia. Hypertonia means increase in the muscle tone. It may occur because of various factors or various conditions. So we can divide the hypertonia into spasticity and rigidity. What is spasticity? In this condition, the muscle tone will rise followed by decrease. So initially, there will increase in the muscle tone, then gradually it will fall. So we call it spasticity. Means the muscle tone or the passive resistance is not continuous. Can you understand? So there will rise of the muscle tone in response to a stretch followed by decrease in the muscle tone. So it is not uniform. the muscle tone is not uniform, it will remain constant. That's why we call it spasticity. So it is a intermittent. So this is called, and it is seen in case of upper motor neuron type of lesion. Upper motor, as we see in case of hemiplegia. So we will see hypertonia in another is a condition known as spasticity. And what is rigidity? In rigidity, the passive resistance will be continuous. Continuous and uniform. There will be no breaking up or rise or decrease. Okay, so this is called rigidity. And rigidity are two types, coagulant rigidity and lead pipe rigidity. What is coagulant rigidity? In coagulant rigidity, the resistance is fluctuating. The tone will be increase, decrease like this. So it is not uniform. And there will be, the tone is intermittent. Can you understand? Rise of tone is intermittent. And in lead pipe type, the tone is, the resistance is against the passive movement. Resistance against the passive movement is continuous. Can you understand? So this is lead pipe type. So there are two types of rigidity, coagulant rigidity and lead pipe type rigidity. So while we will see hypertonia, we will see in condition of upper motor neuron lesion, in Parkinsonism also, right? There is a basal ganglia lesion. Because of the defect in the dopaminergic secretion, you will see hypertonia. Okay? This is hypertonia. Now another important applied aspect you should not forget is hypotonia. What is hypotonia? Hypotonia means decrease in the muscle tone. Hypotonia means decrease in the muscle tone, and it occurs because of many factors. Most important is spinal shock. Spinal shock, you will see hypotonia, any other cerebellar lesion. Cerebellar lesion in lower motor neuron type of paralysis. So hypotonia means decrease in the muscle tone, or it is also called flaccidity or laxity of the muscle. And you will see in case of spinal shock, in cerebellar lesion, and also in lower motor neuron type of lesion. And where you will see hypertonia? Hypertonia you can see in case of decerebration, decerebellectomy, in case of upper motor neuron type of paralysis, in Parkinsonism, in all those conditions. Okay? And where you will see hypotonia? Spinal shock, cerebellar lesions, lower motor neuron type of paralysis. Okay? And another term you should know, what is atonia? What is atonia? Atonia means there is atonia means no tone at all. Atonia means there is no tone of the muscles. Okay? So there is the tone of the muscles are totally absent. We call it atonia. Then another term you should not forget is clonus. Okay, before clonus, we should know what is muscle cramp? Muscle cramp spasm means sudden increase in the tone of the muscle is known as spasm, and muscle cramp is also associated with hypertonia. Okay, so there is a difference between the spasm and the hypertonia. Spasm means not continuous, it is a sudden increase in the tone of the muscle and followed by decrease. Okay, this is for spasm. And you should not forget one important terminology known as clonus. What is clonus? Clonus means, what is clonus? It's a rhythmic contraction of the muscle. It's a rhythmic contraction of a group of muscle. So clonus means rhythmic contraction of a group of muscle. Example, we give ankle clonus, knee clonus. So how it is done? When you stretch, if you give a stretch, suddenly if you give a stretch and you maintain the stretch, you will see clonus. Can you understand? If you suddenly you give a stretch and you maintain the stretch for longer time, you will see clonus. Okay? And actually, it is seen in case of when the muscle spindle is hypersensitive. When muscle spindle is hypersensitive, there will be excessive secretion of the gamma motor neuron discharge, leading to increase in the muscle tone, and ultimately you will see clonus. It's a rhythmic contraction of the group of muscle fibers, and give it because of sudden stretch, and if you maintain the stretch for persistent for longer time, because of increasing stretch or persistent stretch, you will see clonus, a muscle go into a stage of rhythmic contraction, and it is because of hypersensitive muscle spindle or because of pyramidal tract lesion. So in case of pyramidal tract lesion, we will see clonus, which is nothing but the rhythmic contraction of the group of muscle, and it is because of, again I am telling, it is because of the hypersensitive muscle spindle. Okay, so these are the various important points I have tried to cover in when it comes to muscle tone. So again I am telling, how will define muscle tone? So let's summarize. Muscle tone actually is nothing but the partial state of contraction of a muscle. This is the most shortest definition. Partial state of contraction of a muscle, and we can define in a broad way that it is nothing but the passive resistance muscle provides against stretch or any stimulus, and it is due to the contraction of the extrafusal muscle fibers because of the motor neuron discharge, which is asynchronous in nature. Okay, so two important structure is very much important, alpha motor neuron and gamma motor neuron. Via the alpha and gamma motor neuron at the level of spinal cord, muscle tone is maintained, and muscle tone is one more most important structure where muscle tone is regulated is the muscle spindle. All of you know muscle spindle is very much important, and stress reflex is very much pivotal mechanism behind the maintenance of the muscle tone. And without stress reflex, muscle tone cannot be maintained, and both alpha motor neuron and gamma motor neuron plays important role directly or indirectly in control of the muscle tone. Various structures are responsible for controlling of the muscle tone or regulation of the muscle tone. The at level of the spinal cord, stress reflex, inner interneuron, Golgi bodies are responsible for controlling the muscle tone. At suprasegmental level, cerebral cortex, cerebellum, basal ganglia also responsible for inhibition of the muscle tone, and the brain stem is the area where muscle tone is increased or decreased because it has both inhibitory as well as excitatory area. And there are various applied aspects you should not forget: hypertonia, hypotonia, clonus, various type of rigidity, where you will see hypertonia, where you will see hypotonia, and you should not forget. Okay, so here we finish muscle tone. Thank you very much.